In a new interview with reporter Dan Grossman, the CDC director says the Delta variant of COVID-19 outsmarted us. And now she is speaking about how new research suggests that the same amount of the variant can be found in the bodies of both vaccinated and unvaccinated people.
Interesting new study here, and that's making it easier to spread than previously thought. We look at how this has changed the perception of the vaccine and what it means moving forward.
Much of what we understand about COVID-19 can be understood through droplets.
No longer have to explain what studying aerosols means to anyone, because we all know now that this virus is airborne, and those little tiny aerosols can infect you.
Droplets that environmental health professor John Volkens has studied at Colorado State University for the last 20 years, first in terms of pollution, now almost exclusively in terms of the Delta variant of the coronavirus as he informs public health officials about its spread.
The Delta variant is no joke. Like the Alpha variant, it's more transmissible. But the unfortunate reality of Delta is it is about 50% more transmissible than Alpha. What that means is that if you have a town with 10 people who get infected in a cluster, that cluster is not going to produce 10 or 20 more infections. It's going to produce 200 more infections in a matter of days or weeks.
That exact scenario has been seen in Provincetown, Massachusetts, a small town of 3,000 residents that has led to more than 950 new COVID cases ever since the 4th of July holiday. Half of those cases are among residents, while the others are among tourists. The outbreak was so large and so surprising, it has prompted the CDC to update its mask guidance for the entire country. Nearly 74% of the Provincetown cases occurred in vaccinated people, and nearly all of those people have the same amount of virus in their bodies as those who have yet to get the vaccine.
Delta outsmarted us here.
It can be startling to hear that confession from CDC Director Dr. Rochelle Walensky, but this is what's different. After mask guidance was eased for vaccinated people in May, it was believed that the vaccine protected people from spreading the virus about as much as it protected them from getting it in the first place. While breakthrough infections still hover around 1% nationally, those vaccinated people who get it appear to spread COVID just as easily as those who don't have the vaccine. The importance, then, comes in prevention of serious illness and death. Among those 950-plus Provincetown cases, no one has died, and seven people have been sent to the hospital.
And the important thing that is not different about Delta, that our vaccines seem to be working exactly as they did in the clinical trials in terms of preventing symptomatic disease and preventing severe disease and death.
I think there is a bit of a misnomer when you think, I will get the vaccine and never get the virus, because what the vaccine really does is it gives your body the tools to deal with the virus when it gets in there so that it doesn't produce any bad side effects.
The new CDC guidance on wearing masks in places with substantial and high transmission, even for the vaccinated, is then primarily to protect one another, while getting vaccinated is used primarily to protect ourselves. And if these mask regulations become more widespread and reminiscent of a time before they were eased, it will be because the vaccine rates are still behind where the scientists in charge of learning about COVID think it should be to slow this virus's evolution and spread.
Get vaccinated. We know the vast majority of states that are surging have the lowest number, states and counties have the lowest amount of vaccination rates in the country. So those are very much correlated. Lots of disease in areas of low vaccination. So get vaccinated to protect yourself.
I'm Dan Grossman.